Welcome everybody to another Amonkhet Draft. Looking at my first pack here, I have an interesting rare. This is certainly a powerful card if you're black and blue, and it's the type of rare that can incentivize me to draft a controlling deck. Let's take a look at the rest of the pack, see what my options are. Best common is likely Splendid Agony, although Essence Scatter and Thresher Lizard are also pretty strong. Well, I guess if I'm going to take a black removal spell, I should take Rags Riches over Splendid Agony. So we'll start with that. I have my teammate Brock Parker passing to me. Not that that changes the dynamic or anything. All right, so rare's missing. Baleful Amit's strong. Trial of Knowledge is strong. Zenith Seeker is actually not my favorite. Cartouche of Ambition is good, though I would pick this card super high if I already had a trial, but I would not pick it super high in the absence of that. So I guess I'm deciding between Baleful Amit and Trial of Knowledge here. If I do want to build a blue-black control deck, I probably want the trial as a card advantage engine. You don't want to have these decks where you just like cycle, 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 and then you look and your hand has five lands in it. That's kind of lame. You do need a robust, card drawing, card filtering engine. And picking up a trial this early is good. The blue cartouche is quite strong. So while I'm sad to pass the Baleful Amit, if I want to be a creature light control deck, Trial of Knowledge is where I want to be. Well, things are drying up for the deck that I would like to be building. Fanbearer is very strong. And there's also Naga Vitalist. Best card for blue and black is probably Floodwaters, which yuck, I don't want to be third picking that card. So it looks like I will branch out just to, be sure I'm not locking myself into something. If I was to take Fanbearer, I feel like I'm kind of giving up on my first two picks, even though this is the strongest card in the pack. Whereas Naga Vitalist, I could build like a Sultai control deck. And I like green. I like the way green pairs with either blue or black. Sure, I'll take the Vitalist. This is a very bizarre start to a draft, and I really don't know how things are going to go from here. We'll keep our options open, try to do the best. I'll try to do the best that I can. Well, blue cartouche, one of the blue commons that I'm most interested in this point in the draft, since it's great with Trial of Knowledge. And actually, I could build like a green blue dinosaur deck where giving something like Colossipede flying is a nice way to steal wins. Otherwise, I could take Sheltered Thicket. That's a very unexciting pick. Or Colossipede, Seeker of Insight. Yeah, for sure I'm going to take the Cartouche. Ah, pick five, Crocodile of the Crossing. Super strong card and a nice signal for green. Although I will admit that this just looks like an excellent pack. I mean, Gustwalker is also very good. And seeing this pick five is a surprise. But Crocodile is the best card in the pack. And I am, somewhat interested in green, so I'll take that. Otherwise, the Skirmisher, the Bitterblade Warrior are okay, but Merciless Javelineers and Gustwalker are very strong cards too. Pick six. Things are drying up. White does appear to be kind of open, though none of these cards are nearly strong enough for me to want to shift gears. I suppose I could just take Shed Weakness. It's a pretty good combat trick if I do wind up in a green-blue style beatdown deck. I have hardly seen any black cards at all. I guess pick two, the black cartouche, but nothing after that. It's drying up quickly. Sure, I'll take Shed Weakness. And there's some black cards. Wandering Death, Wasteland Scorpion. I don't think I need to take Cancel, Spidery Grasp, or Watchers of the Dead so highly that I can't speculate. So I'll take Wasteland Scorpion just in a... This is sort of just like in a let's continue to see what happens type of mentality, where I can be any combination of green, blue, and black, possibly splashing the third, but we're just, you know, picking Soul Tie cards and taking it from there. Man, I'm not going to take Fanbearer, but passing somebody pick 9 Fanbearer is very remarkable. I'm going to take Quarry Hauler. And Colossipede. Here's an interesting pick. Good beatdown card in Shed Weakness. Note that I do already have one. Good 3-color ramp card in Gift of Paradise. And then good defensive card if I wind up having black as a main color. I'll take Gift of Paradise. I think this is the most, like, I don't know, highest value pick. Now I get a second one right away. Makes me regret it, but sure. Colossipede. So it looks like I'm definitely green with either blue or black or both as a second color. And there's something to wanting to be a beatdown deck with, like, Crocodile of the Crossing, Cartouche of Strength, blue-green beatdown, but it seems more likely that I'm going to be maybe like a ramp slash black-green control type deck where I'm playing big creatures and maybe Rags Riches. So I have some good cards in front of me, but still a lot of work to see exactly where the draft's going to take me. Not the best card in a control deck, but just a really strong green card, and I'm happy to get that sign that green appears to be open. Wow. Well, here's a lot to chew on. I mean, Sandworm Convergence, very unique, powerful, irreplaceable, rare card. 8 mana, which is not ideal, but if I am on track to be a ramp controlling Gift of Paradise type deck, this could be a very useful card. Alternatively, I'm looking for Baleful Amit, but again, not too sure how deep I'm going to go into black. Green Cartouche or Naga Vitalist. Let's rule out the Baleful Amit, even though it is strong, and I'm deciding between Sandworm Convergence, Naga Vitalist, and Cartouche of Strength. If it was early in the draft, I think the Cartouche would be the strongest, most robust pick. However, it does seem like I'm on track to be more of this ramp-type strategy. Let's have some fun. Take Sandworm Convergence. See how this goes for me. Okay. Cycling Land's kind of nice. Quarry Hauler or Ornery Kudu. Let's take a look at the mana curve once more. I generally like Quarry Hauler more as a card than the Kudu. At this point, like, the Kudu fits my curve a tiny bit better, but it's still early enough in the draft that I think I want to take the stronger overall card in Quarry Hauler. Another powerful rare, but unfortunately off color, but I could just try to play, like, the Earth side of this off of a couple of Gifts of Paradise. I'm a little more interested in Final Reward, though. I also need a 2-drop, but I'm going to take the removal spell first. So right now, if the draft finished soon, I guess my deck would look like this, where I'm black and green, but maybe I can cast Riches once in a while off of a Gift of Paradise. Here I'm looking at Quarry Hauler or Evolving Wilds, I suppose. Sure, I'll just take more beasts, more camels. a decent 3-drop when I do need some cards that cost less than 4 mana versus a really strong blue card. But even if I do play blue, I'm not sure that I'm going to have enough blue mana in my deck that I'm reliably Essence Scattering on the second turn of the game. So I'll take, again, the weaker card just to make sure I'm staying on color. Oh, man! Pick 6, Honored Hydra. This is, like, beyond my wildest dreams for something like this to happen. Yeah, I mean, there's nothing really to talk about here. I'd also be thrilled with Cartouche of Strength, but this is just outrageous. This card is awesome. And goes with my theme of trying to ramp into big creatures. Okay, in a pack with nothing that I'm that interested in, I suppose I'll take another Cartouche of Knowledge. And here's Ornery Kudu. Don't need a third Gift of Paradise. My deck is, the card quality is pretty high, and I like the way it's going. I just really need some cards that cost 2 mana. Like, another Naga Vitalist would be the best thing I could hope for. If I could just one-for-one trade in the Sandworm Convergence for the Vitalist that I took it over, I would do so. But part of that's just, you know, the way my curve's been filling out since I made that pick. I don't know if I was to go back in time and face the same pick again, what I would do. Well, everything's just wheeling for me. Now, this is a card that's worth talking about. Since I am nearly mono-green and the cost reduction is actually going to be pretty important. Problem is, you need the cost reduction to be important and the attacking to be important, whereas I seem to be much more of a late-game-centric deck where I don't want to be attacking on, like, the fourth turn of the game. Or I don't care about being attacking on the fourth turn of the game. So I'm just going to take another solid body. And a Haze of Pollen. Sometimes you play... Alright, now if you're really going to twist my arm, I suppose I'll take Ronus's Monument, though I don't know if it's going to make my main deck. Maybe if I wind up doing a blue-green beatdown thing. Two drop. Okay, so I still got to decide what my second color is going to be. And I did open a Mythic Rare in black, but how good is this for me, I'm not sure. Can't attack or block unless a creature under my control died this turn. Sacrifice a creature to do some stuff. Well, that, as much as I am a fan of choosing Mythic Rares when you open them, this one doesn't really seem like it's what I'm in the market for. I mean, first of all, it's in my secondary color. And I did not get hardly any pack black in pack one. So it's not a case where I think I'm going to get a bunch of free Festering Mummies and Doomed Dissenters, like, you know, late in the pack. If that was the case, I could see picking it. But I think I might just take the Naga Vitalist, which I need badly at this point in the draft. This is much more disciplined than I usually like to be in draft, but I think it's going to help me win more. Oh my gosh, these cards are awesome. This is just like a certified bomb, and it's perfect for what my deck's trying to do. I would also be thrilled with Crocodile of the Crossing. Yep, and more green rares. Thank you very much. Essence Scatter, Evolving Wilds, Haze of Pollen. Oh, I almost missed this Edifice of Authority. That's what I want. This is like not quite Icy Manipulator, but pretty close. Sure, so Aven Initiate or Wander in Death are good cards in my second color. I don't think I'm that interested in a Pouncing Cheetah. I think I'm more in the market for Wander in Death than for Aven Initiate. Probably doing the black-green control thing rather than the green-blue beatdown. Festering Mummy, Soul Stinger. Both strong cards, but how much black I'm going to have in my deck could affect how much I want them. Guess I'll just take the green card again. If I have like six swamps in my deck, Festering Mummy is not as good as I want it to be. If I have eight, then yeah, it's the card I want for my mana curve here. But that doesn't look like it's going to be the case. Nothing I want, so I guess this maybe is the card I'm most likely to sideboard in, or this card's okay. Huh. On Crop Champion. Cultivator probably makes my deck, just as a cheap creature, eats up some minus one counters. Do I want another Gift of Paradise? Well, I don't really want anything else. Strong combat trick. That I've never put Nest of Scarabs in a deck, but this could be the deck for it. Quick count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Whatever, I'll take it. I don't think I'll play it. Well, I appear to be basically mono green. So look at what actual mono green would look like. If I wanted to be like a green beatdown deck, let's say. Not quite enough cards, and the cost of playing a second color is very low. I feel like I definitely want to play at least Final Reward. And let's check on the Nest of Scarabs thing one more time. Channeler Initiate, 1. 4 Ornery Kudus, 5. Crocodile of the Crossing, 6. And Quarry Hauler, you can sort of count. Nah, I don't think I want that. Rags to Riches is going to be good if I decide to play these Gifts of Paradise. And that can definitely be a way that I sideboard. I guess the Sandworm Convergence also, this is going to be sort of like a package. So, if I want to do just like a more lean, basic type deck, how many lands do I want to play? I guess 17 if I'm not playing this big stuff. Well, maybe just 17 no matter what. Yeah, I mean, if I just play green with one final reward, play like 12, 5 mana base. That's one reasonable option. And let's see what it would look like if I did want to do a ramp control deck. Probably play all these cards. I would play zero islands since I'm only flashing this back if I draw Gift of Paradise anyway. I'd play probably 11-6. And I would have to cut some of these combat tricks. Maybe still play the Synchronized Strike because it's just so good. Monument would also probably get the axe. And perhaps Hooded Brawler also. I think this looks worse, though. I could see sideboarding into it if this is a game winner against my opponent's deck. I can sideboard in a way to accommodate it. But I think for my main deck, we're going green, somewhat beat down. And I'll skip the Sandworm Convergence. Weird draft. I started out blue-black, ended up mono-green. But I think this deck is pretty good, like above average deck. I do have a couple rares. Honored Hydra is excellent. Good mana. I'm excited to play. I'll see you for round one.